Before we begin with the list of features that we've released in October, I just wanted to give you a quick update on an issue that we've had over the last few days. Actually, these were two separate things were causing performance issues. First one is, with an update, a process went on in the background that slowed down your desktop app significantly, especially on large accounts. The other one is, on Windows only, we mistakenly disabled hardware acceleration. Now we have released version 10.114.4. I suggest you just install that either from the website, you can download it from the website, or you just hit update in our sidebar on desktop, and that should solve all of these performance issues. Apologies for that, and now on with October's feature releases.
Okay, so a lot of stuff happened in October. Let's go through it quickly. Big improvement to the note loading speed, the note list loading speed on mobile. It's up to 3 times faster. There's now a better transition to show the note list. Earlier you had to basically load individually each item that's in the note list, so like the title, the subtitle, all the metadata. Now it all loads in a single query, and it's also much faster. This is very, very cool. It's the first of many gifts that the new performance team has in store for you. Now you can remove thumbnail from a note. Many times, especially when web clipping, you would clip a note and then it would use a weird icon or image as the note thumbnail in the note list for that note. Now you can just remove it. We wanted to actually give you the ability to select specifically which image you want to use for the thumbnail. It turned out to be quite difficult, technical reasons. We still have that in our list, so we want to provide the ability to select manually the thumbnail. But in the meantime, removing the thumbnail was easy, so we released that. Second, so you can now sort notebooks individually. This is a big deal for anybody who's serious about personal knowledge management. Earlier, you had to basically adopt the same sorting for every notebook, every view. Now you can just go inside your recipes notebook and decide that that is going to be sorted by date updated. And instead, maybe you have a notebook that is more an archive or something where you want to sort by title. You can have this notebook sorted by date updated and that notebook sorted by title without having to like manually select the sorting options every time. Now, you can now see another visualization option for the note list on mobile. There are already a bunch of options, but now you can see this title view that just allows you to see so many notes in the list by just showing the title and the edit time or date on the right. Super handy in case you want to quickly see a bunch of different notes more than was previously possible. And of course, the previous options remain. So you have snippets like you see on the left, you also have the cards, etc., etc. Editor improvements. So we have a bunch of editor improvements that we are releasing. So the first one is you can start now a paragraph by clicking at the end of the existing text. Now this is a bit hard to catch, but when you spot it, it will be handy immediately. If you have a bunch of text and you didn't manually create or insert a new line at the end, you might need to like go to the end of the text and then press enter. Now it's just a little detail, but you can just click at the end of the text and a new line will be created for you. There's also another thing, which is create a new line in the same paragraph with shift plus enter. Now again, this is a little detail, but when you have a paragraph on any software that allows you to edit text, really, when you press enter, generally a new paragraph is created, and a paragraph generally has like a little spacing between other items, especially between other paragraphs. Now you can press shift plus enter to create a new line, but in the same paragraph, so without having this little border, this little padding. You can also now attach files to your tables without changing the table layout. So earlier you would insert an attachment to the table and the table would expand to contain the attachment. Now you can just resize the table and the attachment will resize horizontally to match the width of the table. So that was a little issue that many people reported and we loved that we could fix it. There's also a nice little improvement to quoted text. You can now press enter at the end of the quoted text that you're typing to exit the quoted text. The feedback we received is that it was a bit hard to go out of a quoted text. Now you can just like, when you're done typing, you can press enter, it will get you out of the quoted text. Or if you're inside the quote and you're on an empty line, you can just hit delete in order to go out of the quoted block. For instance, if you want to separate two sections of a quote. And that's it. a lot of stuff in October, and hopefully November there will be even more. Thank you for watching, and see you next month.